Penguin Random House New Zealand Audio proudly presents Maori Made Easy, written by Scotty Morrison, adapted by Dave Armstrong, narrated by me, Scotty Morrison. All rights reserved. Production of this audiobook was made possible by the generous support of Manatū Taonga and in partnership with Maori Television. E poho kere ruana a Penguin Random House New Zealand ki te whakaputa I te pukapuka oro, Maori Made Easy. He mea tuhi, nā Scotty Morrison. He mea arotau, nā Dave Armstrong. Ko te reo whakataki, nō kua no, nō Scotty Morrison. Kua tāpuitia katoatia ngā tika o tēnei kaupapa. Nā te Manatū Taonga I tautoko te whakaputanga o tēnei pukapuka oro, ā I mahitahi me whakaata Maori kia puta ai. Maori Made Easy, an introduction. This audiobook is based on my best-selling book, Maori Made Easy, and has been designed for everyday learners of the Maori language, just like you, to accelerate your acquisition and learning of te reo Maori. Since I first launched Maori Made Easy in 2015, I've been blown away by the response. Over 100,000 people have used my books and workbooks to learn and speak te reo Maori. Now, I'm stoked to be able to bring you the complete Maori Made Easy audiobook. You can use this audiobook on its own, or, if you like, you can use it with the Maori Made Easy book, ebook, or series of workbooks. Each audiobook lesson corresponds to 1 week in these books, and each part corresponds to a 30-minute day and is structured to utilize no more than 30 minutes of your precious time. You should feel free to go at your own pace, pausing, listening again, and repeating any lesson anytime you want to. We are all time poor, so when you get that time in your busy schedule to do your Maori language study, that's when you do it. On a walk, in the car, or while doing the dishes. No waiting for your night class to start, no travelling to the local wānanga or university. Press your te reo Maori button and get yourself to an intermediate standard of Maori language expertise. Each lesson in this audiobook introduces the concepts, rules, structures, and vocabulary you will need to kōrero Maori, as well as helpful explanations and fun exercises to help and reinforce your growing knowledge. As my own language learning journey shows, the very best way to learn a new language is by immersion. So throughout this book, you'll hear conversations between two Maori speakers, Mere and Maka, and will listen, repeat, and translate their words, growing in understanding from the start to the end of the lesson and the start to the end of the book. Key vocab and kupu āwhina are provided at the start of every lesson, and a bonus track at the end of the audiobook provides over 350 Maori words for you to learn and practice. Te reo Māori, the learning journey. I began to learn te reo Māori during my first year at university when I was 19. My first year results were mediocre, to say the least, but I began to socialise with native speakers of the language as my interest and understanding of it grew. In my second year, I flattered with two expert native speakers of Māori, and it was during that year that I attained a level of fluency. I was fortunate to be exposed to a more colloquial style of language in our flat, where Māori was basically the favoured language during the whole year, while continuing on with the more formal, textbook-based learning style at university. Based on my experience learning te reo Māori, I now advocate the following pathway for learning a new language. Year 1. Me aro nui. Focus. Me manawa nui. Be determined and tenacious. Me kimi kaiako mātou tautohito hoki. Find an experienced and renowned tutor or lecturer. Me kimi wāhi āhuru. Make sure you feel safe and comfortable in your learning environment. Me whai kaupapa wete wete kōrero māma noiho. Learn grammar but in a light and easy format. Me aro ki te wairua me te hā o te reo. Connect with the essence of the language. Me kimi hoa ako. Find a friend to learn with you. Me aro ki ngā rerenga pū, ki ngā rerenga māma noiho. Keep it simple. Learn the fundamentals. Me ako kupu kōrero e hāngai ana. Learn words and phrases you will use regularly. Me mātaki I ngā kaupapa ako reo ki runga pauaka whakaata. Watch and analyze Māori language learning programs on television. Me whakarongo hoki ki ngā kaupapa ako reo ki runga reo irirangi. Listen and analyze Māori language learning programs on the radio. Me hono atu ki te rautaki reo a tō iwi. Join the language strategy of your tribe or community. Me tāwhai I te reo o tō kaiako o te hunga mātau hoki. Imitate the language style of your tutor and expert speakers. Year 2. Me kimi kaupapa rūmaki. Look for an immersion learning program. Me ako tonu I ngā kupu kōrero e hāngai ana. Continue to learn words and phrases you will use regularly. Me tāwhai tonu I te reo o tō kaiako o te hunga mātau hoki. Continue to imitate the language style of your tutor and expert speakers. Me kimi hoa kōrero Māori, mātau ake I a koe. Find Māori-speaking friends, especially ones more fluent than yourself. Year 3. Me tīmata koe ki te whakarāwai me te whakanikoniko I tō reo. Begin to garnish and adorn your language. Me aro ki te takoto o te kupu. Focus more on grammar. Me tāwhai tonu I te reo o tō kaiako o te hunga mātau hoki. Continue to imitate the language style of your tutor and expert speakers. Kia kaha e hoama me upoko pakaru te karawhiu. A word on dialects. The major differences in language style among the Māori tribes of Aotearoa New Zealand are contained within the pronunciation of words, the vocabulary, and the idioms or figures of speech. For example, in the southwest of the North Island, in the Whanganui and Taranaki regions, the H is not pronounced and is in fact a glottal stop. So the word whenua becomes wenua, and whakarongo becomes wakarongo. If we cross over to the northeast of the North Island to the Tūhoe region in the Eastern Bay of Plenty, NG has merged with N, so words such as kanga, to curse, sound like kana, and tangihanga, funeral, sound like tanihana. In parts of the far north, where the tribes of Ngāpuhi, Te Aupouri, Te Rarawa, Ngāti Hine, Ngāti Kuri, and Ngāti Kahu live, WH has merged with W, to produce a soft whispering sound on the words like whare and whati. They now sound like whare and whati. In the southern South Island dialect, the NG is a K, so you get words like karanga, to call, having its NG replaced by a K to become karaka. North Island tribes call the highest peak of the South Island Aorangi, Mount Cook, but to local tribes of the South Island, it's Aoraki. Some variations in the language come with the spelling of the words, and some obvious examples of this would be taina and taina for younger sibling or relative, toimaha and taumaha for heavy, and tupuna and tipuna, grandparent or ancestor. If you venture over to the east coast of the North Island, you may be greeted with a kaiteaha by the locals. This is another example of regional dialect. For most tribal groups, the equivalent phrase kei te aha means what are you doing? But in the East Coast, it's a form of greeting, which means hello, how are you? Some linguists claim that older speakers of Māori are more likely to speak language identifiable with a particular dialect or region, whereas younger speakers of Māori tend to do a lot of dialect mixing, especially those living in bigger cities. The majority of young Māori speakers are outside their own tribal areas, being taught by people who speak a dialect that is not their own. I remember my Māori language lecturer at Waikato University who was from the Tūhoe tribe in the Eastern Bay of Plenty region, telling me I was starting to sound like a Tūhoe even though I'm from the Te Arawa Confederation of Tribes in the Rotorua area. My main focus at that stage was just to learn the language. Dialect was irrelevant. If you are fortunate enough to be learning your own dialect, great. If you're not, don't worry. It's possible to learn your dialect at a later stage. And anyway, in my opinion, the differences are not huge. Māori ancestors were able to communicate effectively with each other despite dialectal differences. And even in today's setting, a fluent speaker of Māori has no problem understanding other dialects of Māori. My advice to you is not to get too caught up in the dialect debate. At the end of the day, the differences in te reo Māori are probably not even big enough to be termed dialectal. Regional variations may be a more accurate term to describe the current differences in the Māori language. The language in this audiobook is reflective of the Māori language in its entirety, and not necessarily from a particular dialect, but the idioms and proverbs may originate from specific areas. Māori Made Easy, Lesson 1, Part 1. Lesson 1 corresponds to Week 1 in your Māori Made Easy book and in Kete 1 of your Māori Made Easy workbook. Kia ora and welcome to Māori Made Easy. Māori is a phonetic language which, when compared to some other languages, is reasonably simple to pronounce. All that's required is a bit of attention, a dose of respect, and a sprinkle of patience. The key to correct pronunciation is to master the sounds of the five vowels, both short and long. Here's some kupu āwhina to help you with this lesson. Ngārara, insect. Kānga, corn. Whana, kick. Ngoro, lost or missing. Maunga, mountain. Mātanga, expert. Whāwhā, to feel. Whāriki, mat or carpet. To begin, we'll learn the five short vowels. Repeat each one after me. A, pronounced like the A in the word ago. A, ago. E, pronounced like the E in the word egg. E, egg. E, pronounced like the I in the word ink. E, ink. O, pronounced like the AW in the word hawk. Be careful not to say O, like the O in OK. O, hawk. U, pronounced like the U in the word flute. U, flute. Now, let's try them all. Repeat the short vowel sounds after me. A, E, I, O, U. Ka pai. Long vowels have a macron, or a line on top of them, that lengthens the sound. So an A with a macron on it becomes the elongated sound, A. It's extremely important to lengthen the vowel sound if there is a macron present in a word, because it changes the meaning completely. For example, mana means power, control, influence, or authority, while mana is a word denoting possession and translates to for him or her. Now we'll learn the five long vowels. Repeat them after me. Ah, pronounced like the AR in the word far. Ah, far. Air, pronounced like the AI in the word pear. Air, pear. E, pronounced like the EE in the word peep. E, peep. Or, pronounced like the OR in the word store. Or, store. Ooh, pronounced like the OO in the word moon. Ooh, moon. Now, let's try all of the long vowel sounds together. Repeat after me. Ah, e, e, o, u. Well done. Ka pai. If you give the wrong sound to these vowels, whether short or long, you can mess up the correct pronunciation of a Māori name or word. The words taranaki and waikato, for example, are commonly mispronounced because the sound of the vowel a is said flat, like in the word cat. Once you've achieved the correct pronunciation of the vowel sounds, you should have the confidence to dive on in and make an honest attempt to say any Māori word correctly. This is because, apart from the length, the pronunciation of each vowel in Māori words is constant. They always sound the same. When two or more vowels appear next to each other, such as ua, ua, or doubled as in aa, ah, take them slowly at first and pronounce each vowel. For instance, taiapa, fence, wire, to phone. Pouaka, box. Ātāhua, beautiful. However, there are some combinations of vowels that are trickier to master. A plus e equals I, as in yy, leg. A plus e equals I, as in mokai, pet. A plus o equals ao, as in Aotearoa. A plus u equals au, mauhi, mouse. E plus e equals a, teitei, to be high. O plus e equals oi, horoi, to wash. O plus e equals oi, as in koe. O plus u equals ou, as in koutou. By the end of this course, you'll be familiar with these and they'll be far less daunting. Now, let's look at consonants. The 10 consonants in Te Reo Māori are H, K, Ng, M, N, P, R, T, W, F. The pronunciation of these consonants is pretty straightforward. They're similar in sound to the English consonants, though some are a little trickier. The R is very short and slightly rolled. If you can make the purring sound of a cat like this, that's the sound. It almost sounds similar to a D in English, but softer, like the D sound in the word shudder. The WH consonant is usually pronounced as an English F sound, except in the Taranaki region, where it is omitted for a glottal stop. For example, the word whanganui is written with an H in it, but a speaker from the area will say it like this, whanganui. The NG tends to be the consonant sound that gives people the most problems. The NG is said as it sounds in the English word singer. Try not to say the NG as it sounds in finger. It's a softer sound than that. For example, tauranga is pronounced tauranga, not tauranga. The final consonant that may differ slightly from English pronunciation is the T or the T. The pronunciation of this consonant varies depending on which vowel appears after it. When followed by an I or U, it has an S sound, but it's not nearly as prominent as the S sound you hear in English. When followed by an A, an E, or an O, it's pronounced with little or no S sound. Now practice saying these well-known Māori words out loud. And don't be self-conscious. It's a beautiful language. Concentrate on the vowel sounds. They're the key to correct pronunciation of Māori. Firstly, I will say the Māori word slowly, syllable by syllable. Then you repeat after me. Then I'll say the whole word as we would normally. Then you repeat it. Let's go. Ao te a ro a. Now let's join the syllables together. Ao te a roa. Ka ra nga. Karanga. Pa ke ha. Pākehā. Whānau. Whānau. A-ro-ha. Aroha. Tino pai. That was awesome. Now we're going to find out the meaning of some of the words we've been practicing and a few other key Māori words as well. Repeat the Māori word after me. And if you know the meaning in English, say it. Don't worry if you don't know the meaning, because I'll give you the answer afterwards. Bear in mind that some Māori words have more than one meaning. Let's go. Aotearoa. Aotearoa, New Zealand. Aroha. Aroha, love, compassion. Māori. Māori. Normal, usual, pure, and the indigenous people of New Zealand. Mana. Mana. Power, pride, prestige. Haka. Haka. War dance. Koha. Koha. Gift. Karanga. Karanga. To call. Marae. Marae. The enclosed space in front of the meeting house. Moko. Moko, traditional tattoo. Pākehā. Pākehā, person of European descent. Pōwhiri. Pōwhiri, welcoming ceremony. Tangi. Tangi, lament, to cry, a funeral. Taonga. Taonga, treasure, precious. Waiata. Waiata, a song or to sing. Waka. Waka, vessel, vehicle. Whānau. Whānau, family. Whenua. Whenua, land, placenta. Ka mau te wehi. You've just completed the first part of Lesson 1. Keep listening for Part 2. Ka kite anō. Lesson 1, Part 2. Good pronunciation is essential for speaking and understanding te reo Māori. Whakahuatia a waha e nei oro o te reo Māori. Practice saying the following Māori vowels out loud. Let's start with the short vowel sounds. Repeat after me. A, as in ago. E, as in egg. E, as in ink. O, as in hawk. U, as in flute. Ka pai. Now repeat all the short vowel sounds after me. A, e, I, o, u. Now, let's practice the long vowel sounds. Ah, as in far. E, as in pear. E, as in peep. O, as in store. U, as in moon. Now let's try all of the long vowel sounds. Repeat after me. A, e, I, o, u. Great work. Good pronunciation is very important. The longer you say a word incorrectly, the harder it becomes to learn to say it correctly. Bad habits take a long time to break. Let's practice saying some more well-known Māori words. Each of the following words contains the ng sound, the ng. This sound tends to be the most problematic part of pronunciation for most people, apart from the vowel sounds. So remember to make the ng sound similar to that heard in the English word singer. After you've spoken the word in Māori, see if you know the English translation. Don't worry if you don't know the meaning, as I'll give you the answer afterwards. Repeat after me. Maunga. Maunga, mountain. Ngaki. Ngaki, to clear weeds or the garden, or seek revenge. Ngoro. Ngoro. Lost or missing. Ngata. Ngata. Snail. Karanga. Karanga, to call out. The following words provide more practice on the NG sound. However, there are now macrons present on these words, so be mindful of how you pronounce them. Repeat after me. Ngako. Ngako. Heart. Mātanga. Mātanga, expert. Ngārara. Ngārara, insect. Tīrangi. Tīrangi, unsettled. Kānga. Kānga, corn. Kino kēkwe. Now, each of the following words contains the WH sound. Remember, most contemporary Māori speakers pronounce it as an F. Repeat the following WH words after me. After you've spoken the word in Māori, see if you know the English translation. Don't worry if you don't know the meaning, as I'll give the answer afterwards. Whakarongo. Whakarongo, to listen. Whare. Whare, house. Whai. Whai, to follow. It's also the word for a stingray. Whatitiri. Whatitiri, thunder. Whana. Whana, kick. Whenua. Whenua, land or placenta. The following words provide more practice on the WH sound. However, there are now macrons present on these words, so be careful how you pronounce them. As with the other words, see if you can give the meaning of the word in English. Whāriki. Whāriki. Mat or carpet. Whā. Fa, the number four. Fa fa. Fa fa, to feel. Fire. Fire, mother or auntie. Whakahē. Whakahē. To disagree. Koia kayakwe, awesome work. Keep practicing and keep pronouncing the words correctly. Lesson 1, Part 3. Kia ora. Good pronunciation is essential for speaking and understanding spoken Māori well. The following New Zealand place names provide practice on the consonant R. Remember, the R is very short and slightly rolled. If you can make the purring sound of a cat, that's the sound. Now, you try. Excellent. Whakahuatia a waha e nei wahi o te motu. Practice saying the following Māori place names out loud. I'm going to say them twice, then you repeat them after me. Rotorua. Rotorua. Rua Pehu. Rua Pehu. Repo Roa. Repo Roa. Rama Rama. Rama Rama. Rakiura. Rakiura. Kino ke koe. Great work. Now we're going to try more place names beginning with the consonant R. But now these names also have macrons on them. Repeat them after me. Rāwhiti. Rāwhiti. Rāwene. Rāwene. Rua wāhia. Rua wāhia. Rāpaki. Rāpaki. Rua tōria. Rua tōria. The following place names are more difficult and are constantly mispronounced. These names contain lots of challenges, but don't be scared to have a go. Challenge yourself and see how you go. Ngā rua wāhia. Ngā rua wāhia. Whatawhata. Whatawhata. Te kauwhata. Te kauwhata. Whaingaroa. Whaingaroa. Taupō. Taupō. And finally, let's learn the main centres of Aotearoa, starting in the north and heading south. Repeat after me. Tāmaki Makaurau, Auckland. Tāmaki Makaurau. Kirikiri Oroa, Hamilton. Kirikiri Oroa. Te Whanganui Atara, Wellington. Te Whanganui Atara. O Tautahi, Christchurch. O Tautahi. O Te Poti, Dunedin. O Te Poti. Tapu Tapu Ke. See if you can find all the Māori place names you've been practicing on a map of Aotearoa. When I began learning Māori, one of the methods I used to improve my reo was to imitate the style, subtleties, nuances, and flow of expert speakers. I copied the sentence structures and words used by our expert native speakers. So, pick an eloquent speaker of Māori, learn their style, and begin to imitate the way they speak. Tā whaitia te reo e rongo ana koe. Imitate what you're hearing. For this next activity, close your eyes and listen to the five Māori sentences. These sentences are all whakatau ki, or proverbs. They're great to learn because they are one-off statements that are very Māori in meaning and can be used in many contexts. Firstly, listen carefully to how they're being said and try to make the same sounds. Try these many times, not just once. Listen and repeat these whakatauki after me. Then I'll give you the meaning in English and repeat them again in Māori for you to copy. Let's go. Hōhonu ka ki, pāpaku ua ua. Hōhonu ka ki, pāpaku ua ua. Long on words, short on actions. Hōhonu ka ki, pāpaku ua ua. Okea, ururoatia. Okea, ururoatia. Never say die. Okea, ururoatia. Iti noa ana, he pitomata. Iti noa ana, he pitomata. From the withered tree, a flower blooms. Iti noa ana, he pitomata. E kore a muri e hokia. E kore a muri e hokia. What's done is done. E kore a muri e hokia. Kia mau ki te tokanga nui a noho. Kia mau ki te tokanga nui a noho. There's no place like home. Kia mau ki te tokanga nui a noho. That's the end of this part of the lesson. Ka mātua I tēnā. That'll do. Lesson 1, Part 4. In this part, we'll be saying Māori words that are spelled the same but are pronounced differently and therefore have a different meaning. The presence of the makron changes the pronunciation and the meaning. Practice, practice, practice is the only way your pronunciation will improve. At first, speaking Māori might make you feel uncomfortable and unnatural, so you need to practice until speaking the words feels natural and easy. Whakahuatia ā waha e nei takirua o te reo Māori. Practice saying these word pairs. Repeat them after me. Mana, mana. Could you hear how the ā in mana was longer? It has a makron over it when it's written, and the words have different meanings. Mana means power and prestige, whereas mana means for him or her. Let's try again. Mana, mana. Now try aka, aka. Aka means vine, while aka means to clean off or scrape away. Let's try them again. Aka, aka. Wahine, wahine. Wahine refers to one woman, and wahine refers to more than one woman. It's the same with the word tangata. Tangata means a person, while tangata means people. Let's try another. Aku, aku. Both aku and āku mean my, but there are different rules about how they are used. Let's try two more. Toto, toto. Toto means blood, and toto means to tow or weeds. You don't want to confuse those two. Let's try them again. Toto, toto. Now let's try two more. Take, take. Take has a number of meanings, including to originate, while take means to tax. Now let's hear two more. Tana, tāna. Both tana and tāna mean his or hers, but each word has different rules that apply to it. Tana, tāna. You try. Patu, pātu. A patu is a handheld weapon and means to strike or hit, while pātu is a wall. Patu, pātu. Ata, āta. Ata means morning or a reflection or shadow. Āta means gently or slowly. Ata, āta. Pahi, pahi. Pahi is a bus. Pahi means to succeed or pass, as in passing an exam. And it also means purse or wallet. Pahi, pahi. Tapu tapu ke. Great work. Now I'm going to say words we've already tried to pronounce and that we've learned the meaning of. It's your job to repeat the word and say if the word has a macron or not. If it does have a macron, then tell me what letter or letters the macron would sit over. Listen carefully, and I'll say the word twice. Mana, mana. Mana, no macrons. Mana means power or prestige. Āka, āka. Āka, macron on the first A. Āka means to clean off or scrape. Wahine, wahine. Wahine, no macrons. That's the singular form of the word meaning one woman. Aku, aku. Aku, no macrons. Aku means my, plural. Wahine, wahine. Wahine, macron on the first A. This is the plural form, meaning more than one woman. Wahine. Toto, toto. Toto, macron on both O's. Toto means weeds or to tow. Take, take. Take, no macrons. Take means to originate. It can also mean to have a purpose. Tana, tana. Tana, macron on the first A. Tana means his or hers, singular. Patu, patu. Patu, no macrons. Patu means to strike or is a handheld club. Toto, toto. Toto, no macrons. Toto is blood. Pātu, pātu. Pātu, macrons on the A and the U. Pātū is a wall. Aka. 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 No macrons. Aka is a vine. Āku. 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 Macron on the A. Āku means my, plural. Mana. 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 Macron on the first A. Mana means for him or her. Tana. 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 No macrons. Tana means his or hers. Tāke. 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 Macron on the A. Tāke means to tax. Pāhi. 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 Macron on the A. Pāhi means to pass or succeed, or as a purse. Āta. 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 Macron on the first A. Āta means gently or slowly. Kurī. 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 Macron on the I. A kurī is a dog. Koia kai a koe. Well done, my friend. Lesson 1, Part 5. In this part of the lesson, we're going to go over many of the words used in this week's pronunciation exercises. Your challenge is to listen to my friends, Mere and Marka, and then repeat the words they say. Then you have to translate the words into English. I'll then give you the correct answers. It would be great if you could use your cell phone or some other device to record yourself, so you can listen to what you sound like speaking te reo Māori. Let's go, Marka.
Maunga.
Maunga, mountain.
Ngaki.
Ngaki, to clear weeds or seek revenge.
Ngaro.
Ngaro, lost or missing.
Ngata.
Ngata, snail.
Karanga.
Karanga, to call or to call out.
Ngākau.
Ngākau, heart.
Mātanga.
Mātanga, expert.
Ngārara.
Ngārara, insect.
Tīrangi.
Tīrangi, unsettled.
Kānga.
Kānga, corn.
Whakarongo.
Whakarongo, listen.
Whare.
Whare, house.
Whai.
Whai, follow. And also the word for a stingray.
Whatitiri.
Whatitiri, thunder.
Whana.
Whana, kick.
Whenua.
Whenua, land or placenta.
Whāriki.
Whāriki, mat or carpet.
Whā.
Whā, the number four.
Whāwhā.
Whāwhā, feel.
Fire.
Fire, mother or auntie.
Whakahē.
Whakahē, disagree. Ka pai. Now, Marka and Mere will say the proverbs we learnt earlier. It's your job to repeat the proverb in Māori and then give the translation in English. I'll then give you the correct answers. Don't worry if you can't translate them all or straight away. Okea ururoatia, never say die. Just keep listening to them over and over and you'll understand them eventually.
Hohonu kaki, pāpaku ua ua.
Hohonu kaki, pāpaku ua ua. Long on words, short on actions.
Okea ururoatia.
Okea ururoatia. Never say die.
Iti noa ana he pitomata.
Iti noa ana he pitomata. From the withered tree, a flower blooms.
E kore a muri e hokia.
E kore a muri e hokia. What's done is done.
Kia mau ki te tokanga nui a noho.
Kia mau ki te tokanga nui a noho. There's no place like home. Kuia kai a koe. That means you're awesome, all right. And the reason you're awesome is that you've got to the end of your very first lesson. Have a break, then you can crack on to lesson two. Tapu tapu ke, choice. Lesson 2, Part 1. Lesson 2 corresponds to Week 2 in your Maori Made Easy book and in Kete 1 of your Maori Made Easy workbook. Learning how to count in Maori is obviously going to be critical as your knowledge of the language grows. It does take quite a bit of time and practice, but hopefully by the end of these sessions, you'll be familiar with numbers in te reo Maori. Here's some kupu āwhina to help you with this lesson. Mati mati, finger. Mārau, fork. Whakautu, answer. Puka puka, book. Pūngā were were, spider. Kura, school. Tāne, man. Tōtiti, sausage. Let's begin to count from 0 to 10. Repeat the numbers after me. Kore, 0. Kore. Tahi, 1. Tahi.
Rua. Two. Rua. Toru. Three. Toru. Fa. Four. Fa. Rima. Five. Rima. Ono. Six. Ono. Fitu. Seven. Fitu. Waru. Eight. Waru. Iwa. Nine. Iwa. Teko. Ten. Teko. Kapai. Good work. Now I'll say some numbers in Māori and you repeat and translate them. I'll then give you the answers. Rua. Rua. Two. Ono. Ono. Six. Iwa. Iwa. Nine. Toru. Toru. Three. Kore. Kore. Zero. Fa. Fa. Four. Tekau. Tekau. Ten. Rima. Rima. Five. Tapu tapu ke. Choice. Now we're going to learn to count from 11 to 20. See if you can recognize a pattern in these numbers. Repeat the numbers after me. Tekau mā tahi. 11. Tekau mā tahi. Tekau mā rua. 12. Tekau mā rua. Tekau mā toru. 13. Tekau mā toru. Are you getting the idea? Can you guess what 14 will be? Tekau mā whā. 14. Tekau mā whā. Tekau mā rima. 15. Tekau mā rima. Tekau mā ono. 16. Tekau mā ono. Tekau mā fitu. 17. Tekau mā fitu. Tekau mā waru. 18. Tekau mā waru. Tekau mā iwa. 19. Tekau mā iwa. Rua tekau. 20. Rua tekau. Rua tekau mātahi. 21. Rua tekau mātahi. Ten is tekau. 20 is rua tekau. Can you guess what 30 will be? Toru tekau. 30. Toru tekau. Whā tekau. 40. Whā tekau. Rima tekau. 50. Rima tekau. Ono tekau. 60. Ono tekau. Fitu tekau. 70. Fitu tekau. Waru tekau. 80. Waru tekau. Iwa tekau. 90. Iwa tekau. And now we get to 100. Kotahi rau. 100. Kotahi rau. Ka pai. Now, Marka and Mere are going to say some numbers in Māori. It's your job to repeat the number and then translate it into English. I will then give you the answer.
Tekau.
Tekau, 10.
Rua.
Rua, 2.
Ono.
Ono, 6.
Rua tekau.
Rua tekau, 20.
Kotahi rau.
Kotahi rau, 100.
Whā tekau.
Whā tekau, 40.
Fitu tekau.
Fitu tekau, 70.
Toru.
Toru, 3.
Tahi.
Tahi, 1.
Waru.
Waru, 8.
Rima tekau.
Rima tekau, 50.
Kore.
Kore, 0.
Tekau mā whā.
Tekau mā whā, 14.
Tekau mā tahi.
Tekau mā tahi, 11.
Ono tekau.
Ono tekau, 60.
Tekau mā rima.
Tekau mā rima, 15. Koia kai a koe. You're awesome, all right? To end this session, we're going to learn how to use ordinal numbers, such as first, second, and third. For example, how would I say she came first, or I live on the 6th floor. Ordinal numbers, used for ranking between 1 and 9, require the prefix tua. I'll give you some examples and you repeat them after me. Tuatahi, first. Tuatahi. Tuarua, second. Tuarua. Can you guess what third would be? Tuatoru, third. Tuatoru. Now we're going to put tuafa, or fourth, into a sentence. Don't worry if you don't exactly understand how the sentence works. Just repeat it. Now repeat after me. I tuafa ia. He or she came fourth. I tuafa ia. Wāhanga tuarima. Chapter 5. Wāhanga tuarima. Kei te papa tua ono tōna whare. His or her apartment is on the 6th floor. Kei te papa tua ono tōna whare. Kāpai. Ordinal numbers from 10 upwards require no prefix. So if you wanted to say 15th, you simply say tekaumarima, which is the same as 15. Marka and Mere are going to give us some place numbers in Māori between the 1st and 20th. Repeat what they say, then translate into English. I'll give you the answer after that.
Tekau mā ono.
Tekau mā ono, 16th.
Tekau mā toru.
Tekau mā toru, 13th.
Tuatahi.
Tuatahi, 1st.
Tuarima.
Tuarima, 5th.
Tekau mā tahi.
Tekau mā tahi, 11th.
Tekau mā waru.
Tekau mā waru, 18th. Ka mau te wehi. You'll be an expert at counting in te reo in no time. But for now, ka mātua I tēnā, that'll do. Lesson 2, Part 2. In this part, we're going to practice ordinal numbers. First, second, third, etc. Let's recap. Ordinal numbers used for ranking between 1 and 9 require the prefix tua. For example, to say 5th in Māori, I would say tuarima. Ordinal numbers of 10 and above do not need a prefix. To say 13th, I would simply say tekau mā toru. Marka and Mere will say the ordinal numbers in Māori. You will repeat the ordinal number in Māori, then translate into English. After that, I'll give you the answer.
Tuawhitu.
Tuawhitu. 7th.
Tuatahi.
Tuatahi, first.
Tuaono.
Tuaono, sixth.
Tuatoru.
Tuatoru, third.
Tuarima.
Tuarima, fifth.
Tuarua.
Tuarua, second.
Tuawaru.
Tuawaru, eighth.
Tuafa.
Tuafa, fourth.
Tuaiwa.
Tuaiwa, ninth. Now, Marka and Mere will describe some numbers in Māori. You may not have heard some of these numbers before, but you should be able to work them out. Repeat the number in Māori and see if you can work out the translation into English. Don't worry if you don't get all of them correct. Have a go. I'll give you the answer afterwards.
Toru te kau mā toru. Toru te kau mā toru.
Toru te kau mā toru, 33.
Rua te kau mā tahi. Rua te kau mā tahi.
Rua te kau mā tahi, 21.
Ono te kau mā ono. Ono te kau mā ono.
Ono te kau mā ono, 66.
Rua te kau mā waru. Rua te kau mā waru.
Rua te kau mā waru, 28.
Iwa te kau mā iwa. Iwa te kau mā iwa.
Iwa te kau mā iwa, 99.
Whā te kau mā toru. Whā te kau mā toru.
Whā te kau mā toru, 43.
Whitu te kau mā ono. Whitu te kau mā ono.
Whitu te kau mā ono, 76.
Toru te kau mā iwa. Toru te kau mā iwa.
Toru te kau mā iwa, 39.
Rima te kau mā waru. Rima te kau mā waru.
Rima te kau mā waru, 58.
Toru te kau mā tahi. Toru te kau mā tahi.
Toru te kau mā tahi, 31.
Rima te kau mā rima. Rima te kau mā rima.
Rima tekau mā rima. 55.
Fitu tekau mā iwa. Fitu tekau mā iwa.
Fitu tekau mā iwa. 79.
Iwa tekau. Iwa tekau.
Iwa tekau. 90.
Whā tekau mārua. Whā tekau mārua.
Whā tekau mārua. 42.
Tekau mā toru. Tekau mā toru.
Tekau mā toru. 13.
Waru tekau mā rima. Waru tekau mā rima.
Waru tekau mā rima. 85. And finally,
kotahirau.
Kotahirau, 100.
That's the end of this part of the lesson. Ka mātua I tēnā. That'll do. Lesson 2, Part 3. In this session, we're going to learn how to ask how many items or objects there are. To ask how many, we use e hia. For example, e hia ngā waka. This means how many cars are there. We say ngā waka because we're asking about more than one car. Let's assume there are five cars. To reply to e hia ngā waka, we say e rima ngā waka. There are five cars. If we want to answer that there is just one car, we say kotahi te waka. We use te instead of ngā and not tahi but kotahi. Kotahi te waka. There is one car. Kotahi is used whether we are talking about a person or an object. Now, Marka and Mere will ask some questions involving numbers. You will repeat the question in Māori and then try and translate the question into English. Let's try a question from Mere.
E hia ngā āporo.
We know that Mere is asking how many because she began the question with e hia.
E hia ngā āporo.
Do you know what āporo means? It means apple, and because she used ngā, she's asking how many apples are there. Repeat Mere's question, then see if you can translate it into English.
E hia ngā āporo.
E hia ngā āporo. How many apples are there? Now Mere is going to tell us how many apples there are. See if you can repeat her answer in Māori, then translate it into English.
E fitu ngā āporo.
E fitu ngā āporo. There are seven apples. Now Marka will ask a question. Repeat it, then translate it into English.
E hia ngā matimati.
E hia ngā matimati. How many fingers are there? Repeat Marka's answer in Māori, then translate it into English.
e rima ngā matimati.
E rima ngā matimati. There are five fingers. Ka pai. Now Mere will ask a question. Repeat it in Māori, then translate it into English.
E hia ngā hoiho.
E hia ngā hoiho. How many horses are there?
Kotahi te hoiho.
Kotahi te hoiho. There is one horse. Note that when there is just one thing, we give the number one as kotahi. We also drop the e and replace the ngā with te. Kotahi. Te hoiho. There is one horse. Now Māka and Mere will use kotahi in sentences. Repeat the sentences in Māori. I will then give you the English translation. In these sentences, we can translate kotahi to mean there is only one.
Kotahi te rangatira.
Kotahi te rangatira. There is only one leader.
Kotahi te whakautu.
Kotahi te whakautu. There is only one answer.
Kotahi te māngai mō tātou.
Kotahi te māngai mō tātou. There is only one spokesperson for us.
Kotahi te rongoā.
Kotahi te rongoā. There is only one remedy. When asking the question how many, always use the plural form ngā. Like this, e hia ngā āporo. If you ask e hia te āporo, then you are already saying there is only one apple. So what's the point of asking how many there are? When you answer the e hia questions, simply remove the question word hia and replace it with the correct number. Now, Māka and Mere will ask you how many items there are. You will repeat the question after them and translate it into English. Then I will give you the answer in English. You will translate that answer into Māori. I will then give you the answer so you can check if you were correct.
E hia ngā pene.
E hia ngā pene. How many pens are there? There are four pens. E whā ngā pene. There are four pens.
E hia ngā pukapuka.
E hia ngā pukapuka. How many books are there? There are six books. E ono ngā pukapuka. There are six books.
E hia ngā rākau.
E hia ngā rākau. How many trees are there? There is only one tree. Kotahi te rākau. There is only one tree. Notice that because there is only one tree, we begin the sentence with kotahi and use te instead of ngā.
E hia ngā waka.
E hia ngā waka. How many canoes are there? There are two canoes. E rua ngā waka. There are two canoes. Ka pai. Now I'm going to say some sentences in English involving numbers, and you're going to translate them into Māori. Whakamāoritia ēne rerenga kōrero. The Māori word for spider is pūngā werewere. Pūngā werewere. See if you can say, there are 27 spiders. Start your sentence with e, then translate 27, or 2, 10 and 7, which is rua tekau, mā whitu. There is more than one spider, so we say ngā pūngā werewere. Now try and put that all together. There are 27 spiders. E rua tekau mā whitu ngā pūngā werewere. Ka pai. Now try, there is one bird. Kotahi te manu. There is one bird. Now try, there are two mountains. E rua ngā maunga. There are two mountains. There are 94 leaves. E iwa tekau mā whā ngā rau. There are 94 leaves. The word for plain is waka rererangi. Waka rererangi. There are 6 planes. E ono ngā waka rererangi. There are 6 planes. There are 100 restaurants. Kotahi rau, ngā whare kai. There are 100 restaurants. The Māori word for chemist is whare rongoā. Whare rongoā. There are 3 chemists. E toru, ngā whare rongoā. There are 3 chemists. There are 10 schools. Tekau, ngā kura. There are 10 schools. Note that we say tekau, ngā kura, not e tekau, ngā kura. The Māori word for shoes is hū. There are 52 shoes. E rima tekau mā rua ngā hū. There are 52 shoes. The word for camera is tā whakāhua. Tā whakāhua. There are 67 cameras. E ono tekau mā whitu ngā tā whakāhua. There are 67 cameras. Ka pai. If there were any words used or numbers that you weren't sure of, go back and listen to the lesson again. It gets easier the second time. Lesson 2, Part 4. When asking how many people there are, you can use the prefix toko. When responding, you use toko when the number of people being spoken about is between 2 and 9. Listen to Marka and Mere's questions and copy them. I will translate their questions. When Marka and Mere give their answer, which will include a number, try and copy it, then translate it into English. I will give the answer so you can check. Let's go.
Tokohia ngā tāngata.
Tokohia ngā tāngata. How many people?
Tokowaru ngā tāngata.
Tokowaru ngā tāngata. There are 8 people.
Tokohia ngā tamariki.
Tokohia ngā tamariki. How many children?
Tokotoru ngā tamariki.
Tokotoru ngā tamariki. There are 3 children.
Tokohia ngā wāhine o tēnei kapa.
Tokohia ngā wāhine o tēnei kapa. How many women in this team?
Tekau mā rua.
Tekau mā rua. 12. Notice I didn't use toko, as we only use this prefix for numbers between and including 2 and 9.
Tokohia ngā tāne I haere.
Tokohia ngā tāne I haere. How many men went?
Ko tahi rau ono tekau mā whā.
Ko tahi rau ono tekau mā whā. 164.
Tokohia ngā tāne.
Tokohia ngā tāne. How many men are there?
Toko ono ngā tāne.
Toko ono ngā tāne. There are 6 men.
Tokohia ngā wāhine.
Tokohia ngā wāhine. How many women are there?
Tokowaru ngā wāhine.
Tokowaru ngā wāhine. There are 8 women.
Tokohia ngā tamariki.
Tokohia ngā tamariki. How many children are there?
Tokotoru. Ngā tamariki.
Tokotoru ngā tamariki. There are 3 children.
Tokohia ngā kōtiro.
Tokohia ngā kōtiro. How many girls are there?
Tekau mā toru ngā kōtiro.
Tekau mā toru ngā kōtiro. There are 13 girls.
Tokohia ngā tama.
Tokohia ngā tama. How many boys are there?
Kotahi te tama.
Kotahi te tama. There is one boy.
Tokohia ngā koraua.
Tokohia ngā koraua. How many old men are there?
Tekau mā tahi ngā koraua.
Tekau mā tahi ngā koraua. There are 11 old men.
Tokohia ngā kuia.
Tokohia ngā kuia. How many old women are there?
Tokowaru ngā kuia.
Tokowaru ngā kuia. There are 8 old women.
Tokohia ngā pēpi.
Tokohia ngā pēpi. How many babies are there?
Kotahi te pēpi.
Kotahi te pēpi. There is one baby.
Tokohia ngā māma.
Tokohia ngā māma. How many mothers are there?
Tokorua ngā māma.
Tokorua ngā māma. There are 2 mothers.
Tokohia ngā kaitākaro.
Tokohia ngā kaitākaro. How many players are there?
Tokorima ngā kaitākaro.
Tokorima ngā kaitākaro. There are 5 players. Ka pai. Now let's see how you go with translating some English phrases involving numbers into Māori. Whakamaoritia ēnei rerenga kōrero. I will say a sentence in English that involves numbers, and you try and say the same sentence in Māori. There are 7 men. Tokowhitu ngā tāne. There are 7 men. There is 1 baby. Kotahi te pēpi. There is 1 baby. There are 2 fathers. Tokorua ngā pāpā. There are 2 fathers. There are 74 players. E whetū tekau mā whā ngā kaitākaro. There are 74 players. There are 100 people. Kotahi rau ngā tāngata. There are 100 people. There is 1 person. Kotahi te tangata. There is 1 person. There are 9 girls. Tokoiwa ngā kōtiro. There are 9 girls. There are 54 boys. E rima tekau mā whā. Ngā tama. There are 54 boys. There are 6 teachers. Toko ono ngā kaiako. There are 6 teachers.
Did you get that? Ka wanike. That's the end of this part of the lesson. Ka kite anō. Lesson 2, Part 5. When asking how many items or objects are required, we use the phrase kia hia. What do you think Marka is asking?
Kia hia ngā puka puka.
He is saying, how many books? Now listen to him again.
Kia hia ngā puka puka māu.
This time he's saying, how many books do you want? Don't worry about how the word māu, which means for you, works. We'll learn about that later. Now let's hear Marka and Mere asking and answering kia hia questions in Māori. Repeat them, then try and translate them into English. I will then give you the answers.
Kia hia ngā puka puka māu.
Kia hia ngā puka puka māu. How many books do you want?
Kia whitu ngā puka puka.
Did you understand Mere's answer? She wants 7 books. Kia whitu ngā puka puka. 7 books. She could also say,
kia whitu ngā puka puka māku.
Kia whitu ngā puka puka māku. Māku means for me. So she's saying, 7 books for me, or I want 7 books. Are you thirsty? Let's have another question from Marka.
Kia hia ngā inu.
Kia hia ngā inu. How many drinks? Or Marka could also say,
kia hia ngā inu māu.
Kia hia ngā inu māu. How many drinks do you want? Let's see if Mere is thirsty.
Kia rua te kau mā whā ngā inu.
Kia rua te kau mā whā ngā inu. 24 drinks. Homai means can I have or give me. Let's hear exactly what kai or food Marka wants. Remember, tōtiti means sausage. What do you think hēki are?
Homai kia kotahi te tōtiti, kia rua ngā hēki.
Can you hear that Marka wants one of something, kotahi, and two, rua, of something else? Have another listen.
Homai kia kotahi te tōtiti, kia rua ngā hēki.
Homai kia kotahi te tōtiti, kia rua ngā hēki. Can I have 1 sausage and 2 eggs? Ka pai. Now Marka and Mere will ask each other the number of things they want. Listen carefully for the numbers. I'll give you the answers. But before we start, let's revise a couple of new terms. Māu means for you. Māku means for me. And homai means give me. Let's go.
Kia hia ngā āporo māu.
Kia hia ngā āporo māu. How many apples do you want? Let's hear Marka's answer.
Kia te kau mā ono ngā āporo māku.
kia tekau mā ono ngā āporo māku. 16 apples for me. Now it's Marka's turn to ask Mere what she wants.
Kia hia ngā tōtiti māu.
Kia hia ngā tōtiti māu. How many sausages do you want?
Kia whā ngā tōtiti māku.
Kia whā ngā tōtiti māku. 4 sausages for me. Now it's Mere's turn to ask the question.
Kia hia ngā inu māu.
Kia hia ngā inu māu. How many drinks do you want?
Kia waru ngā inu māku.
Kia waru ngā inu māku. 8 drinks for me. Now Marka is asking Mere how many of a certain food she wants.
Kia hia ngā heki māu.
Kia hia ngā heki māu. How many eggs do you want?
Kia ono ngā heki māku.
Kia ono ngā heki māku. 6 eggs for me. Now Marka wants something to read. Let's hear what Mere asks him.
Kia hia ngā puka puka māu.
Kia hia ngā puka puka māu. How many books do you want?
Kia tekau mā iwa ngā puka puka māku.
Kia tekau mā iwa ngā puka puka māku. 19 books for me. Marka's got a lot of reading to do. But it looks like he's making Mere a coffee first.
Kia hia ngā huka māu.
Kia hia ngā huka māu. How many sugars do you want?
Kia toru ngā huka māku.
Kia toru ngā huka māku. 3 sugars for me. Marka is hungry, but he needs something to eat with.
Kia hia ngā mārau māu.
Kia hia ngā mārau māu. How many forks do you want?
Kia kotahi te mārau māku.
Kia kotahi te mārau māku. 1 fork for me. And Marka probably needs something to go with his fork.
Kia hia ngā māpiri māu.
Kia hia ngā māripi māu. How many knives do you want?
Kia kotahi te māripi māku.
Kia kotahi te māripi māku. 1 knife for me. Mere's happy just having a drink, but needs something to stir in the 3 sugars.
Kia hia ngā koko iti māu.
Kia hia ngā koko iti māu. How many teaspoons do you want?
Kia rua ngā koko iti māku.
Kia rua ngā koko iti māku. 2 teaspoons for me. After dinner, Marka is off to coach 2 soccer teams at once.
kia hea ngā pōro māu.
Kia hea ngā pōro māu. How many balls do you want?
Kia rua tekau mā rua ngā pōro māku.
Kia rua tekau mā rua ngā pōro māku. 22 balls for me. Ka pai. Now, you're going to translate the following sentences into Māori. Whakamāoritia, ēnei rerenga kōrero. I'll give you the answers once you've had a go. Use the word homai, which means give to me, at the start of each sentence. Whakamahia te kupu homai ki te timatanga o ia rerenga. Let's go. I will have 3 eggs. Ho mai, kia toru ngā hēki māku. I will have 3 eggs. I will have 30 drinks. Ho mai, kia toru tekau ngā inu māku. I will have 30 drinks. I will have 2 teaspoons. Ho mai, kia rua ngā koko iti māku. I will have 2 teaspoons. I will have 6 bananas. Ho mai, kia ono ngā maika māku. I will have 6 bananas. I will have 99 pens. Ho mai, kia iwa tekau mā iwa ngā pene māku. I will have 99 pens. I will have 2 coffees. Ho mai, kia rua ngā kafe māku. I will have 2 coffees. I will have 7 rugby balls. Ho mai, kia fitu ngā pōro futupōro māku. I will have 7 rugby balls. I will have 15 light bulbs. Ho mai, kia tekau mā rima ngā pūaho māku. I will have 1 fork. Ho mai, kia kotahi te mārau māku. I will have 1 fork. I will have 1 knife. Ho mai, kia kotahi te marepi māku. I will have 1 knife. And that's the end of our second lesson, kino ke koe, which means, gee, you're the one. If you found any of this difficult, go back and listen to the lesson again. If not, get ready to say kia ora to lesson 3.
Lesson 3, Part 1. Lesson 3 corresponds to Week 3 in your Maori Made Easy book and in Kete 1 of your Maori Made Easy workbook. Greeting people, asking how they are, and replying. But first, here's some kupu āwhina to help you with this lesson. Ingoa, name. Kare, dear friend. Toa, shop. Moenga, bed. Ngahau, party or to be enjoyable. Ora, well, healthy. Pukumahi, busy. Ia, he or she, him or her. To start this lesson, listen to this conversation between Mere and Marka. Don't worry if you don't understand all the words.
Tēnā koe.
Kia ora.
Kei te pēhea koe.
Kei te pai au. Kei te pēhea koe.
Kei te pai au. Nō hea koe.
Nō Rotorua au. Nō hea koe.
Nō Tāmaki Makaurau au. Ko wai tō ingoa.
Ko Māka. Ko wai tō ingoa.
Ko Mere.
Kei te haere koe ki hea e Mere.
Kei te haere au ki te toa.
Ka pai te tūtaki ki a koe e Mere. Hei te wā.
Ai, ka kite anō i a koe.
There are two ways you can greet someone in Māori. Kia ora or tēnā koe.
Tēnā koe.
Kia ora.
Some people say that kia ora is more informal than tēnā koe, but I believe both are equally appropriate greetings in informal and formal settings. Kia ora or tēnā koe will usually be accompanied by a handshake and a hongi, the pressing of noses. Now, we're going to greet you. To reply, you can use either tēnā koe, literally, there you are, or kia ora, literally, I wish you good health, in response.
Tēnā koe.
Kia ora.
Tēnā koe.
Kia ora.
Kia ora.
Tēnā koe.
Ka pai. If we want to ask someone how they are, we say, Kei te pēhea koe. How are you?
Kei te pēhea koe.
You try. Kōrero mai. Starting a sentence with kei te means that you are talking about something happening right now, in the present tense. If we add the word pēhea, kei te pēhea means how is or how are. If we add a koe, which means you, we are asking, how are you?
Kei te pēhea koe.
How are you?
Kei te pai au.
Pai is the word for good. Kei te pai au means I'm good. O is the word for I or me. If anyone asks you a question containing the word koe, you, you will answer O in response.
Kei te pēhea koe.
Kei te pai au.
Mere is going to greet you, then ask how you are. See if you can respond.
Tēnā koe. Kei te pēhea koe.
Ka pai. Now you try greeting Marka, then ask him how he is. Kōrero mai.
Kia ora. Kei te pai au.
Ka pai. Now listen again to Mere and Marka greet each other.
Tēnā koe.
Hello.
Kia ora.
Hello.
Kei te pēhea koe.
How are you?
Kei te pai au.
I'm good.
Kei te pēhea koe.
How are you?
Kei te pai au.
I'm good. Now you know how to greet someone and how to be greeted. And you can ask how someone is and tell people how you are feeling. But the answer to kei te pea hea koe is not always going to be kei te pai au. What if you're not feeling good?
Kei te pea hea koe.
Kei te hia kai au.
Kai means to eat. So, can you guess what hia kai means?
Kei te pea hea koe.
How are you?
Kei te hia kai au.
Mark is feeling hungry. Hia kai. Now you try saying that you're hungry when Mere asks how you are.
Kei te pea hea koe.
Kei te hia kai au. Now, let's find out how Mere is feeling.
Kei te pea hea koe.
Kei te hia inu au.
Can you guess how Mere is feeling? Inu means to drink. So can you guess what hia inu means?
Kei te pea hea koe.
How are you?
Kei te hia inu au.
I'm feeling thirsty. Now answer these questions from Mere and Marka in Māori. I'll give you the answer first in English.
Kei te pea hea koe.
I'm thirsty. Kei te hia inu au.
Kei te pea hea koe.
I'm hungry. Kei te hia kai au. Ka pai. Now, ask Marka how he's feeling. Kōrero mai.
Kei te tino ora au.
Ora means well and healthy. And tino ora means you're extremely well.
Kei te tino ora au.
Say that you're extremely well. Kōrero mai. Kei te tino ora au. Now ask Mere how she's feeling.
Kei te māwiwi au.
Can you guess what māwiwi means? Ka pai, Mere is sick.
Kei te māwiwi au.
Now ask Marka how he's feeling.
Oh, kei te ngenge au.
He sounds tired and worn out, which is what ngenge means.
Oh, kei te ngenge au.
Now try answering these questions in Māori. I'll give you the answer in English first, then in Māori, so you can check if you were right.
Kei te pea hea koe.
I'm tired. Kei te ngenge au.
Kei te pea hea koe.
I'm sick. Kei te māwiwi au. Ka pai. Let's see how Mark is doing. Kei te pea hea koe, e Marka?
Kei te pukumahi au.
Mahi means work. So what do you think pukumahi means? Ka pai. Marka is very busy. Pukumahi.
Kei te pukumahi au.
Say, I am busy in Māori. Kōrero mai. Kei te pukumahi au. You now know several responses to the question, kei te pea hea koe, or how are you? Listen to the different responses from Marka and Mere to kei te pea hea koe and see if you can translate them into English. I'll give you the translation afterwards so you can check your answer.
Kei te pea hea koe.
Kei te pai.
I'm good.
Kei te pea hea koe.
Kei te tino ora au.
I'm extremely well.
Kei te pēhea koe.
Kei te māuiui.
I'm sick.
Kei te pēhea koe.
Kei te pukumahi au.
I'm busy.
Kei te pēhea koe.
Kei te hia inu au.
I'm thirsty.
Kei te pēhea koe.
Kei te hia kai au.
I'm hungry. Now let's answer Mere and Marcus' questions. I'll give the answer in English first, and you answer in Māori. Then I'll give the answer in Māori, so you can check if you were right.
Kei te pēhea koe.
I'm busy. Kei te puku mahi au.
Kei te pēhea koe.
I'm hungry. Kei te hia kai au.
Kei te pēhea koe.
I'm good. Kei te pai au.
Kei te pēhea koe.
Oh, I'm sick. Kei te māuiui au.
Kei te pēhea koe.
I'm thirsty. Kei te hia inu au.
Kei te pēhea koe.
I'm extremely well. Kei te tino ora au.
Kei te pēhea koe.
I'm tired. Kei te ngenge au. And I'm tired after that. If you found some of those sentences difficult, feel free to listen to this part of the lesson again. But for now, ka mātua I tēnā. That'll do. Lesson 3, Part 2. So far, we've learnt two of the three singular personal pronouns. They are koe, which means you, and o, which means I or me. The third singular personal pronoun is ia, which can mean he or him, or it can mean she or her. Just like koe and o, ia is not gender specific, so you may use it to talk about a male or a female. Let's practice singular personal pronouns. Look around you and find two objects to represent people. One of the objects will be the person you are speaking to, koe, and the other object is the person you are speaking about, ia. If Marcus says ko koe, point to the object that represents the person you are talking to and repeat what Marcus says. If Marcus says ko ia, point to the object representing the person you are speaking about, but look at the object that represents the person you are speaking to. Then repeat what Marcus says. If he says ko au, point to yourself and repeat what he says.
Ko au. Ko ia. Ko koe. Ko ia. Ko koe. Ko au.
Ka pai. Now it's time to copy Mere and use personal singular pronouns in a question. Repeat in Māori the question that Mere asks. I will then translate into English.
Kei te pēhea au?
How am I?
We won't use that question very often, but it's still good to practice.
Kei te pēhea koe?
How are you?
Kei te pēhea ia?
How is he or how is she? Before we translate some sentences into English, let's learn some new words to describe how we are feeling.
Kei te pērā tonu au?
That means I'm still the same.
Kei te pērā tonu au?
Is Marka feeling still the same?
Kei te pukuriri au?
Can you guess what pukuriri means?
Kei te pukuriri au?
Marka is annoyed, or pukuriri. What about Mere? How is she feeling?
Kei te hōhā au?
Mere sounds like she's over it. She feels hōhā. She's had enough.
Kei te hōhā au?
Now try and translate these sentences into English.
Kei te ngenge ia?
He is tired.
Kei te pukumahi ia?
She is very busy.
Kei te pērā tonu au?
I'm still the same.
Kei te pērā tonu ia?
He's still the same.
Kei te hiakai ia?
She is hungry.
Kei te hia inu koe?
You are thirsty.
Kei te māwiwi au?
I am sick.
Kei te pukuriri ia?
She is annoyed.
Kei te hōhā ia?
He is over it. Ka pai. Now I will say something in English and you will translate it into Māori. Compare your answer with Mere and Marka's. He is very busy.
Kei te pukumahi ia?
You are thirsty.
Kei te hia inu koe?
I am still the same.
Kei te pērā tonu au?
She is hungry.
Kei te hia kai ia?
She is annoyed.
Kei te pukuriri ia?
He is extremely well.
Kei te tino ora ia?
She is tired.
Kei te ngenge ia?
I am over it.
Kei te hōhā au?
And that's the end of this part of the lesson. Ka mātua I tēnā. That'll do. Lesson 3, Part 3. Kia ora. Let's start by listening again to some of the dialogue we heard at the beginning of the lesson.
Nō hea koe.
Nō roto rua au. Nō hea koe.
Nō tāmaki makaurau au. Ko wai tō ingoa.
Ko māka. Ko wai tō ingoa.
Ko mere.
Māka and mere are asking each other where they are from.
Nō hea koe.
Where are you from? They are also asking each other their name.
Ko wai tō ingoa.
What is your name? Let's learn to tell people where we come from and ask them where they come from. We have a new sentence starter, nō. It means from. We also have a new question word, hea, meaning where. These two words combined, nō hea, mean where from. Add the personal pronoun koe and we get nō hea koe, or where are you from? See if you can copy Marka and ask, where are you from?
Nō hea koe.
Nō hea koe. Where are you from? Copy Marka and Mere as they ask, then answer this question.
Nō hea koe.
Nō whangarei au.
I am from Whangārei.
Nō hea koe.
Nō tāmaki makaurau au.
I am from Tāmaki makaurau, or Auckland.
Nō hea koe.
Nō kirikiri roa au.
I am from Kirikiri roa, or Hamilton.
Nō hea koe.
Nō o Tautahi au.
I am from O Tautahi, or Christchurch.
Nō hea koe.
Nō te whanganui a Tara au.
I am from Te Whanganui a Tara, or Wellington. Now, Mere is going to ask you where you are from. See if you can answer. If you don't know the Māori name for the place you live, try and find out.
Nō hea koe.
I live in Tāmaki Makaurau, so my answer is nō Tāmaki makaurau au. Once we've asked someone where they are from, we can ask them their name. Copy the question Marka asks.
Ko wai tō ingoa.
Ko wai tō ingoa. What is your name? Our new question word is wai, or who. So we are literally asking, who is your name? The word ingoa means name. The possessive particle tō means you or your. So ko wai tō ingoa means what is your name. Mere wants to know my name.
Ko wai tō ingoa.
Ko Scotty. Now it's your turn to answer the question.
Ko wai tō ingoa.
The question words we have been introduced to so far are pēhea, or how, hea, or where, and wai, or who. To answer the following questions, simply replace the question word with the appropriate response. You don't need to change any other words in the sentence. Listen to Mere ask Marka how he is.
Kei te pēhea koe.
Kei te pai au.
Nō hea koe.
Nō roto rua au.
Ko wai tō ingoa.
Ko māka.
Ka pai. Let's do some practice. Answer these questions from Marka and Mere.
Tēnā koe.
Kei te pēhea koe.
Nō hea koe.
Ko waito ingoa.
Now see if you can greet me, ask how I am, where I come from, and what my name is. I will answer after each gap. First, say hello to me. Kōrero mai. Tēnā koe. Now have a go at asking me how I am. Kei te pai au. Now ask me where I come from. Nō tāmaki makaurau au. Now ask me my name. Ko Scotty au. Ka pai. Now, let's learn a couple of other ways to address people. E hoa is used for a friend. E kare is used for a dear friend. Repeat after me.
E kare.
E kare, or dear friend.
E hoa.
E hoa, or friend. See if you can translate the following sentences into English. I will give the translation afterwards so you can check your answer.
Kei te pēhea koe, e hoa.
How are you, my friend?
Kei te pukuriri au e kare.
I am annoyed, my dear friend.
Kei te pukumahi au e kare.
I am very busy, my dear friend.
Kei te hōhā ia e hoa.
He's over it, my friend. Let's learn a few other ways of addressing people. We can address an elderly man with e koro.
Tēnā koe e koro.
Tēnā koe e hoa.
We can address an elderly woman with e kui.
Kia ora e kui.
Kia ora e kare.
It may sound strange in English to call someone old lady or old man, but in Māori, these words are normal terms of respect. See if you can translate these questions into Māori. I'll give you the answer after you've had a go, so you can check if you're right. How's it going, old man? Kei te pēhea koe, e koro. What's your name, old lady? Ko waito ingoa, e kui? Are you busy, dear friend? Kei te pukumahi koe, e kare? Are you hungry, friend? Kei te hia kai koe, e hoa? I know all that learning has made me hungry. That's the end of this part of the lesson. Feel free to take a break for some kai before the next part. Ka kite anō. Lesson 3, Part 4. There are two sentence structures we are going to learn, so we can ask someone where they are going. The first, kei te haere koe ki here, literally means going you to where, or where are you going? Repeat the phrase after marker.
Kei te haere koe ki here.
Kei te haere koe ki hea. Where are you going? The second way of asking this question is ki hea tō haere, which means where are you off to? Repeat the phrase after mere.
Ki hea tō haere.
Ki hea tō haere. Where are you off to? Sometimes a short answer to these questions is all that is required. Listen to these examples.
Kei te haere koe ki hea.
Where are you going?
Ki te toa.
To the shop. Now, Marka will ask you where you are going, and you will reply that you are going to the shop.
Ki hea tō haere.
Ki te toa. To the shop. Let's learn some other places we might go. Whare Wānanga is the university. Whare Wānanga. When Marka asks where you are off to, tell him you are going to the university.
Ki hea tō haere.
Ki te whare Wānanga. To the university. Ngaho means party. Ngaho. When Mere asks you where you are going, tell her that you are going to the party.
Kei te haere koe ki hea.
Ki te ngaho. To the party. Moana means beach. Tell Marka you're going to the beach.
Kei te haere koe ki hea.
Ki te moana, to the beach. A whare is a house or building, and kanikani means to dance. Can you guess what a whare kanikani is? It's a nightclub, whare kanikani. Tell Mere you're off to a nightclub.
Ki hea tō haere.
Ki te whare kanikani, to a nightclub. Kāinga means home. Tell Marka you're going home.
Ki hea tō haere.
Ki te kāinga, I'm going home. The word moi means to sleep. Can you guess what moinga means? It means bed. Tell Mere you're off to bed.
Ki hea tō haere.
Ki te moinga. To bed. A helpful word to know is wharepaku or toilet. Tell Marka that you're off to the toilet.
Ki hea tō haere.
Ki te wharepaku, to the toilet. A hui is a meeting. Tell Mere that you're going to a meeting.
Kei te haere koe ki hea.
Ki te hui, to a meeting. Ka pai. You can now tell people some different places you might be going to. Kei te haere au means I am going. Now try and translate the following sentences into English. I'll give the translation afterwards so you can check the answer.
Kei te haere au ki te whare kanikani.
I am going to the nightclub.
Kei te haere au ki te moinga.
I am going to bed.
Kei te haere au ki te hui.
I am going to a meeting.
Kei te haere au ki te wharepaku.
I am going to the toilet.
kei te haere au ki te kāinga.
I am going home.
Kei te haere au ki te whare wānanga.
I am going to the university.
Kei te haere au ki te ngahau.
I'm going to the party.
Kei te haere au ki te toa.
I'm going to the shop.
Kei te haere au ki te moana.
I am going to the beach. Ka pai. Now you try saying the following sentences in Māori. I am going to the university. Kei te haere au ki te whare wānanga. I am going to the university. Now say, I'm going to the toilet. Kei te haere au ki te whare paku. I'm going to the toilet. Now say, I'm going to a meeting. Kei te haere au ki te hui. I am going to a meeting. Now say, I am going to the beach. Kei te haere au ki te moana. I am going to the beach. Now say, I am going to the shop. Kei te haere au ki te toa. I am going to the shop. Now say, I am going home. Kei te haere au ki te kāinga. I am going home. Now say, I am going to the nightclub. Kei te haere au ki te whare kanikani. I am going to the nightclub. Now say, I am going to the party. Kei te haere au ki te ngahau. I am going to the party. Now say, I am going to bed. Kei te haere au ki te moinga. I am going to bed. Ka mau te wehi. Awesome work. That's the end of this part of the lesson. Feel free to listen to this part again. But ka mātua I tēnā. That'll do for now. Lesson 3, Part 5. Te reo Māori provides a variety of ways to bid a person farewell at the end of a conversation. Listen to Marka and Mere end their meeting.
Kei te haere koe ki hea, e Mere.
Kei te haere au ki te toa.
Ka pai te tūtaki ki a koe, e Mere. Hei te wā.
Ai, ka kite anō I a koe.
Marka used hei te wā to end his conversation with Mere. I would translate this, or mā te wā, as catch you later. Mere replies with ka kite anō I a koe, or see you again soon. These two ways of farewelling a person, ka kite anō I a koe, and hei te wā, are simple and can be used in any situation. Now you try copying Marka and Mere as they say goodbye.
Hei te wā.
Hei te wā. Catch you later.
Ka kite anō I a koe.
Ka kite anō I a koe.
See you again soon. Now I'll farewell you in English and you translate into Māori. I'll repeat the phrase in Māori so you can check your answer. Catch you later. Hei te wā or mā te wā. Catch you later. Let's try another one. See you again soon. Ka kite anō I a koe. See you again soon. You might remember Marka saying this just before.
Ka pai te tūtaki ki a koe.
Marka is saying, it's a pleasure to meet you, Mere. It's always a winning line to pull out of the bag when you're meeting someone for the first time. Listen to Marka say it and then copy.
Ka pai te tūtaki ki a koe.
Ka pai te tūtaki ki a koe. It's a pleasure to meet you. Now listen to Marka again as he talks to Mere.
Ka pai te tūtaki ki a koe e Mere.
Do you think you can work out how to say, it's a pleasure to meet you, Scotty? Did you say, ka pai te tūtaki ki a koe, Scotty? If you did, it's a pleasure to meet you too. Ka pai te tūtaki ki a koe. Now let's hear how Mere responds to Marka farewelling her.
Ka pai te tūtaki ki a koe, Mere. Hei te wā.
It's a pleasure to meet you, Mere. Catch you later.
Ai, ka kite anō I a koe.
Yes, see you again soon. You might remember that you heard a conversation between Marka and Mere at the very beginning of this lesson. Listen again to this kōrerorero and see how much of it you now understand.
Tēnā koe.
Kia ora.
Kei te pēhea koe.
Kei te pai au. Kei te pēhea koe.
Kei te pai au. Nō hea koe.
Nō roto rua au. Nō hea koe.
Nō tāmaki makaurau au. Ko wai tō ingoa.
Ko Māka. Ko wai tō ingoa.
Ko Mere.
Kei te haere koe ki hea e Mere.
Kei te haere au ki te toa.
Ka pai te tūtaki ki a koe e Mere. Hei te wā.
Ai, ka kite anō I a koe.
Let's hear it again, line by line, and see if you can translate each sentence. I'll give you the answer after you've had a go.
Tēnā koe.
Hello.
Kia ora.
Hello.
Kei te pēhea koe.
How are you?
Kei te pai au. Kei te pēhea koe.
I'm good. How are you?
Kei te pai au. Nō hea koe.
I'm good. Where are you from?
Nō Rotorua au. Nō hea koe.
I'm from Rotorua. Where are you from?
Nō Tāmaki Makaurau au. Ko wai tō ingoa.
I'm from Auckland. What's your name?
Ko Māka. Ko wai tō ingoa.
Māka. What's your name?
Ko Mere.
Mere.
Kei te haere koe ki hea e Mere.
Where are you going to, Mere?
Kei te haere au ki te toa.
I am going to the shop.
Ka pai te tūtaki ki a koe e Mere. Hei te wā.
It was a pleasure to meet you, Mere. Catch you later.
Ai, ka kite anō I a koe.
Yes, see you again soon. Ka pai. Now we know the two ways of farewelling someone. Mā te wā, hei te wā, and ka kite anō can be used in any situation. They differ from terms such as haere rā, which is only used when you are saying goodbye to a person who is leaving, and e noho rā, which is only used by the person who is leaving to those who are staying. Repeat these words of farewell after Mere and Māka say them.
Haere rā.
E noho rā.
Now listen to Māka and Mere farewell each other. You have to decide each time whether it's Māka or Mere who's leaving the room. Remember, you say haere rā to the person who is leaving and e noho rā if you are the one leaving.
E noho rā.
Māka is leaving.
Haere rā.
Māka is leaving.
Haere rā.
Mere is leaving.
E noho rā.
Mere is leaving. And that's the end of Lesson 3, Ka Wanike, which means fantastic. You've done really well to get this far, but keep going and you'll get much better. Until next time, hei te wā. Lesson 4, Part 1, Action Phrases. Lesson 4 corresponds to Week 4 in your Maori Made Easy book and in Kete 1 of your Maori Made Easy workbook. Here's some kupu āwhina to help you with this lesson. Kāinga, home. Hīkoi, walk. Kōtiro, girl. Listen to this conversation between Mere and Māka. Don't worry if you don't understand all the words. Just listen.
E Māka, kei te aha koe I tēnei rā?
Kei te haere au ki te moana?
Kei te aha a heni?
Kei te haere mai ia?
Kei te whakaheke ngaru kōrua?
Kei te whakaheke ngaru au, engari kaore a heni e whakaheke ngaru ana?
Ka pānui pukapuka ia?
Ai, koira tana tino mahi.
Koia kei āia. Kaore au e pānui pukapuka, hōhā tērā.
Kei te kata au I tō kōrero.
Kei te haere au ki te kāinga o Mere I nāianei, ka kite I ā koe ā pōpō, ne?
Ai, mā te wā.
During earlier sessions, you were introduced to your first tense marker, kei te. Starting a sentence with kei te means that you're talking about something that's happening now, in the present tense. We're going to learn some action phrases in the present tense. Basic action phrases consist of a tense marker, then a verb, then an agent of the action. Let's look at an action phrase and see how it works.
Kei te haere ia.
The first part, kei te, tells us that we are in the present tense. The second part,
haere,
is the verb. Do you know what it means? It means going. The third part is the agent of the action. Who or what is going?
Ia.
Ia means he or she.
Kei te haere ia.
He or she is going.
Now listen to Marka describe where this person is going to.
Kei te haere ia ki te toa.
Ki te means to the. Marka is saying he or she is going to the shop. Can you work out what Mere is saying?
Kei te haere au ki te moinga.
Mere is saying, I am going to bed. Try and translate these other action phrases into English.
Kei te haere ia ki te whare kanikani.
He is going to the nightclub.
Kei te haere koe ki te kāinga.
You are going home. Now, let's learn some more action words. Hikoi means to walk. Hikoi. And oma means to run. Oma. Repeat each action phrase in Māori after Marka and Mere say it, then translate it into English. I will give you the answers afterwards.
Kei te hikoi au ki te toa.
Kei te hikoi au ki te toa. I am walking to the shop.
Kei te oma ia ki te kāinga.
Kei te oma ia ki te kāinga. He or she is running home.
Kei te oma koe ki te whare kanikani.
Kei te oma koe ki te whare kanikani. You are running to the nightclub.
Kei te hikoi au ki te moinga.
Kei te hikoi au ki te moinga. I am walking to bed. Now let's learn some new words and put them into sentences in the present tense. We call a father papa and a mother mama, a bit like in English. The verb to sit is noho and the verb to stand is to. Repeat the phrases that Marka and Mere say in Māori and then translate them into English. Kōrero mai.
Kei te noho te mama.
Kei te noho te māma. The mother is sitting.
Kei te tū te papa.
Kei te tū te papa. The father is standing. Ka pai. Let's learn the name of some domestic animals. Ngeru means cat. And the word for dog is kurī. Repeat, then translate these phrases into English. Kōrero mai.
Kei te hikoi te ngeru.
Kei te hikoi te ngeru. The cat is walking.
Kei te moi te kurī.
Kei te moe te kurī. The dog is sleeping. Now translate the following into Māori. The dog is walking. Kei te hikoi te kurī. The cat is sleeping.
Kei te moe, te ngeru. The father is standing. Kei te tū, te pāpā. The mother is sitting. Kei te noho, te māma. Ka pai. Now, translate my action phrases into Māori. Each sentence will start with kei te, followed by a verb, followed by the agent or doer of the action. She is running to the shop. Kei te oma ia ki te toa. I am going to bed. Kei te haere au ki te moenga. She is running to the university. Kei te oma ia ki te whare wānanga. You are walking to the nightclub. Kei te hīkoi koe ki te whare kanikani. She is running to the beach. Kei te oma ia ki te moana. I am going to a meeting. Kei te haere au ki te hui. He is walking home. Kei te hīkoi ia ki te kāinga. Tēnō pai. Beginning a sentence with kei te indicates we are in the present tense. But we can also use another phrase structure beginning with e and containing ana after the verb, which also indicates present tense. For example, e haere ana au means I am going. What do you think e haere ana koe means? It means you are going. Ka pai. Let's hear some examples of the two different present tense markers, kei te and e ana. See if you can translate mere and marker's phrases into English. I'll give you the answers once you've had a go. Kōrero mai.
E oma ana ia.
He or she is running.
Kei te oma ia.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.